forward with Arizona Senators John McCain and John Kyle. Why can't you get that border secure? President Obama says that they've sent more forces down there. They've spent all this money. What's the problem?
I think the problem is twofold. One, it's a lack of will to see it through. I mean, you can conduct a war, you can be fighting a war, but not do it effectively. You can spend a lot of money, but not deploy it.
Is that what's happening here?
Yes, I think so. And then second is the problem of resources themselves. But with the expenditure of relatively small amount of resources, I think we can achieve what we need.
President Obama is the one who has the authority, ultimate authority, but why? What happens when you tell him?
If I could just take a run at that. As a member of the Judiciary Committee, we have asked both Attorney General Holder and Homeland Security Secretary Napolitano for the plan to do what we just talked about. How much will it cost? What do we need to do? For a year and a half, we didn't get the information. For a year, we didn't get it, so we passed a law saying that we wanted the information by December 27th of last year. We still await that information from these two government departments.
What do they say when you call over and say, where is it? I mean, especially with the Homeland Security Secretary Janet Napolitano, she used to be your governor.
Well, and I understand from her department that they're waiting to get it from the Attorney General's office.
Who's waiting to get it from the Department of Homeland Security? Who's waiting to get it from the White House? Who's waiting? There's another point here. The deputy head of the Border Patrol said the area down near our border is like a third world country. Our citizens should not be condemned to living in an area of the United States of America that's, quote, like a third world country.
Unprotected.
And there are signs up. When the next time you hear someone say, well, the border is, quote, more secure, whatever that means, then why does the federal government have to put up signs that I think you took pictures of that says, warning, this is a drug smuggling and human smuggling area, be careful, et cetera, et cetera. Those are put up by the government
along
to
the
warn
route
our citizens.
And not on the border.
North of our border.
North of the border on Route 8, is it?
Yes, just south of Route 8, north of our border. So you can understand why people who live there would feel this insecurity, which is translated, very frankly, when Rob Krentz, the rancher, was murdered, into anger. John and I Saturday were there, and people are very angry. And we watched people with tears in their eyes talking about this situation. It's very moving.
So what do you tell President, do you get a chance to talk to President Obama about this? I realize that you've got the Secretary Napolitano and Attorney General Holder going back and forth, but what about President Obama?
John was with him recently.
Yes.
Well, I think there's a view that they want to do it through the mechanism of comprehensive reform. Politically, comprehensive reform isn't going to happen anytime soon, certainly not until the border's secure. So in effect, they set up an impossible condition. Now, they will say also, well, we are still putting resources against this. We're trying. And our only argument is we understand what needs to be done. You need to employ those resources smartly, the way that the people on the border believe that they should be employed. And if you do that, we can secure the border, but it's not being done right now.
You can understand the frustration of the American people is that, you know, we sit and we listen to this and we know the border's insecure. We've heard that over and over, and we've seen, you know, some of us have even seen the signs where it says beware. Some of us have read about, you know, the horrible violence. Some of us have heard about people being stuffed in, you know, trucks and boiling to death in the heat. We've all seen that. But then we sit and the people we send to Washington, you know, work this out. You know, help us. You know, how do we get everyone to work this out for us?
It's a matter of federal policy. It's the president saying to the Director of Homeland Security and the Attorney General, get it secure. How much money do you need? Maybe a couple of billion dollars? That's probably all that's necessary. Look at where it has worked. San Diego, Del Rio, Texas, Yuma, Arizona. What are they doing there that works? Do the same thing in the Tucson sector.
How's Governor Brewer doing?
She's doing fine. She's been standing up for our state, and that, of course, brings up the issue that we found out on Ecuadorian television about that the fact that the Attorney General is going to bring suit against the state of Arizona. And I watch Ecuadorian television a lot. I just must have missed that one. Rather than notify the governor of Arizona, which is a courtesy that I think should have been extended to her, we find out on Ecuadorian television. And apparently the suit is going to be about whether the state of Arizona has the jurisdiction over this issue or not. The state of Arizona would never have acted if it hadn't been for their frustration over the lack of the federal government carrying out its responsibilities.
And of course you got the boycotts.
Well, hopefully people have calmed down a little bit and realized that if you call for a boycott on business doing business in Arizona, you're probably going to hurt the very folks that you'd like to try to help. These are folks that are at middle income at best, who have jobs in our tourism industry, for example, or in our construction industry. And they're the ones that would be hurt by a boycott. So that makes no sense whatsoever. By the way, I wish those people who talk about a boycott would read the Arizona law.
Senators, thank you both very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.